First talked with the scientists at Inovio when they came up with a vaccine candidate back in April. Now, people have gotten that vaccine as part of their clinical trials with the goal of rolling out up to 1 billion doses by next year.
And I really do truly hope that people, you know, the general public can see that as a light at the end of the tunnel, because I certainly know how frustrating and confusing and scary these times are.
While Dr. Kate Broderick and her team were developing a vaccine to protect against COVID-19, her sister, a nurse, was diagnosed with the disease. She knows how critical it is to stop SARS-CoV-2.
I really think that there's some promising data coming out of the vaccines that are being tested at the moment.
Originally designed by sequencing the virus samples out of China, scientists at Inovio Pharmaceuticals came up with a vaccine candidate. They first tested it on 40 people. It was safe. Then 100 volunteers got the shot.
Specifically, so we're also looking at people in what we call an elderly cohort, so those above 65 years old. And that's really important because generally, historically, unfortunately, as you get older, the way you respond to vaccines is less and less efficient.
And those are the same people more gravely impacted by a COVID-19 diagnosis. Some hope today, as those who got the shot then mingle in the community, constantly monitored for infection.
So far, we've had some really great responder rates. So that means the number of people that are showing really positive results against the vaccine. So that's really, really encouraging.
Inovio is part of the government's Operation Warp Speed, tasked with not only coming up with a vaccine, but also beginning the manufacturing process to make sure if it works, it's ready.
But by 2021, I think the public should feel fairly confident that there's going to be vaccines available. We're all going very fast, but we're going fast on the manufacturing side of things. We're going fast on the logistical side of things. I just want to reiterate that there is not a single corner being cut on the safety side of things. All the normal safety tests for any vaccine under any circumstances are still being utilized here.
And so far, the original vaccine candidate is holding up, despite recent studies showing some mutation of SARS-CoV-2 making it spread more easily.
Our vaccine is still based on that first sample from China. However, the way that we designed our vaccine, it's really sort of got a lot of coverage. So the mutations that we've seen so far in the virus are still within the realm of our vaccine. So we're not concerned about the mutation rates that we're seeing.
And as we move forward, as we begin to vaccinate people, will this virus get smart and mutate much the way the flu does?
We're not seeing any evidence of that at the moment. And so that gives me certainly comfort, and I'm sure the whole scientific community, the case that we're not going to see those levels of mutation that we do with the flu and with other viruses.
And in the absence of an effective treatment, the vaccine is the best hope for beating back COVID-19 and getting back to a greater sense of normalcy.
The dedication, the hard work, the determination from the team of scientists literally working day and night, because we all know how critical this situation is.
Inovio is moving this summer into phase 2-3 trials, which means even more people getting the vaccine. And they're looking for volunteers to test it. We have all of the information on our website. Back to you.
Thank you, Dina.